Eu Não. Muchacho.
Que é que tem desse vai ter que ter um pouco de.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإياكم ومحدثات الأمور فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us and made us different from so many of his creations. Allah has given us aql with which we are able to think, and aql means that you are able to know the right from the wrong, and once you are able to know it, it's not just a matter of knowing it, but more important than that is acting upon it. So when Allah gives us this aql, so that you can know the facts and the truth and then act on it and believe in it, it is important for us also to know how are you going to act on it, on what you are allowed to and what you can't do and what you can do. Now, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, if we see those who are the enemies of Islam, they are basically everybody, including many who call themselves Muslims. And only if you go and study Quran and Sunnah in the historic history of Islam and those things which happened before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was even born, and those things which happened in his lifetime, and those things which happened in the lifetime of as-Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in, many things will come and answers would be given without asking anybody else. If you know what enemies of Islam they are keeping for us, the amount of hatred they keep against us, the opportunities which they are looking for, any opportunity to come and destroy us, things which are happening where they do not declare openly that they fight Muslims or they want to destroy and kill you, but would come under different agendas and different names, there are too many. If you know how much they hate us, you would never have a single moment in your life where you would rest, but you would be fully awake, finding out ways to defend and protect the honor which Allah has given you. And there is no other better honor than the honor of Islam which Allah has given you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear when he said, لَتَجِدَنَّ أَشَدَّ النَّاسِ عَدَاوَةً لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الْيَهُودَ وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا, that you will see that those who are the most severe enemies of Muslims are those who call themselves Jews and who are pagans, mushrikeen. Now, for a person to be a Jew, it does not mean that he has a certificate, a birth certificate, a driving license, a passport in which it is written he is a Jew. And for a person to be a mushrik, he does not need to be born in India, which is, looks like is the core of all the mushrikeen, or where majority of them they live, at least those who worship idols. No. You can be anywhere. You could be calling yourself any name. You could be hidden behind so many agendas which nobody would know of. And even you may not know about it. Meaning that the person who is a part of one of either being a pagan or a Yahudi. But what is important to us to know what these people are and how to keep yourselves protected from it. I would like to go back today, 1430 years ago, in Ma'rakat al-Khandaq, the Battle of Trench, the Battle of Ahzab, when Salman al-Farsi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who originally is a Persian from Iran, who kept on looking for truth from being a child of those who worship fire, then on his long journey he ends up in Medina, because he was guided that this is the place where the Prophet would come, which ends up being really what it was told to him, what he was told. Salman al-Farsi and the other Sahabas, they are digging that trench to protect Medina from outside invaders. Now, in the duration of that, when they were digging the trench, there was this big rock, very solid. And it was a special of Salman al-Farsi. He was the one who was doing it there. And he had very mighty shoulders. He was meaning that he had a lot of strength and he could not break it. So he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking him to help him. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wanted to tell Rasulullah, look, we cannot dig from here. Why don't we divert a little bit and dig from the other side? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, give me the ma'wal, the pick. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started to hit it. Allah has given him certain powers, including that he was as strong as 30 men. And this is authentically recorded. And the blessings of Allah which comes to him whenever Allah wants to give it to him, alayhi salatu wasalam. So he hit it for the first time. And he said, Allahu Akbar. And Salman al-Farsi is saying that the light came out. I could not verify the authenticity of this particular word. But al-Muhim Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Qad ada ali, that I have been given by the light, or he could see in the vision, Kisra, Qasr room, that the palace of the Romans. And then he hit it for the second time. Then he was shown the palace of Kisra, Al-Bayla, the white palace of Kisra, which was in Iran. Then for the third time, on the third hit, he was shown the palaces of Yemen. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam promised the Sahabas that this is what you people are going to conquer, and it will belong to the Muslims. Now, this was said in the fifth year of Hijrah. After that, by 11 years, Salman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Dharar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he sallallahu alayhi wasallam had said that he was not a Muslim, but he heard about it and he became a Muslim later on. All these people are moving towards that side, and that is al-Mada'in, where this palace in the surroundings were. Now we are talking about 150 to 160 kilometers odd away from the current Baghdad. And all of these things are happening in Iraq and Iran. Now, to understand more, this place was overpowered and taken by Persians, known as Fus. Now, these people, they worshipped fire as their official religion. So whatever battles which took place between the Sahabas and whoever came later on, till today, it is not about the region, it's about the belief and religion. And that is, those Persians, they thought and still believe that Islam came and Muslims, and then they include Arabs, they have taken this land from us. It belongs to our forefathers, the worshippers of the fire, and so forth. This thing I'm saying, it started 1430 years ago, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave the glad tidings in the Battle of Trench. And now, 11 years later, those Sahabas, they are walking in to take that place. They know the promise of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and how these things are going to happen. The force that kept on losing all their battles is others, the Romans on the other side. They hadith wala haraj keep on saying, and everything almost happened as it is being written in the historical events such as Al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya Ibn Kathir, Tariq al-Umam wal-Muluk Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, and so many other historical books. Now, then they were moving and conquering, walhamdulillah. In the end, we see that these Persians, they ran to the other side of the river known as Ad-Dijla. In English, they call it Tigris, River of Tigris, which is one of the major rivers. The other one is Euphrates, and this one, Tigris. And they took all the boats and seized all the other boats so that the Muslims, they cannot cross from this side of the river to the other side. And it was around the month of March at that time, when the river flow is very high, all flooded and very hard to cross to the other side without boats. And now they were well fortified in that palace there out on the other side. And then they thought that never ever the Muslims will be able to come and take over them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wanted it to happen, and that is what will happen, and definitely would happen when Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he gets there, likes of Ka'ka and others amongst them. These are all famous names in the battles of Islam. Amazing they were. We only know few such as Khalid ibn al-Walid, but Ka'ka was nothing less than Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa anhum ajma'in. Now they had to cross this river. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, the commander, he did istikhara. And he saw a vision, and he did understand from that they would cross it to the other side. He, from his 60,000 soldiers, chose as volunteer who would go to the other side. 600, they decided to be the first ones. Among those, another 60 were chosen to be the first ones, then the next 600, and the 60,000 soldiers to follow later on. They went inside the river. Of course, the patients, they could not believe that they are crossing. It never came in their mind that they would cross this river, regardless of whatever it is. So the patients, they decided to send their soldiers inside so that they could fight the Muslims in the river, which was a big mistake by them. And they ended up losing the battles, because when you send your own soldiers and they mix with the Muslims, they are not able to attack. The patients were not able to attack from that side because their own people were there mixed with the Muslims. They could not sling, they could not throw bows and arrows or anything like that, or spears. The Muslims, they took care of them, and then they penetrated there, and in a matter of very limited time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them victory, including that the entire army could cross the river and come to the other side and took their place. Now, we see that the Kisra, the emperor, he lost and he ran away, and everything was granted to the Muslims. And Darar ibn al-Khattab, he gave the takbir again and said that this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, had promised us, and today we are taking it. Now all of them, they ran away, they dispersed here and there, minor, small crowds, big crowds. Then they decided to stand and have at least last stand. And Mahran was one of them, as a Qaid and few others. And then they decided to have their final of the stages being set up in Jalula. There they dug lots of trenches and they fortified themselves. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he asked the permission from Umar ibn al-Khattab, and then he sends Ka'ka radiallahu ta'ala anhu with 12,000 soldiers, and they were able to siege the place. And it continued for about 7 or 8 months, and it was very difficult till in the end they decided that the Persians, they decided to come out and fight the Muslims, which they did. But that was the end of them, because the Muslims, they kept on fighting them, al-Mujahidun, and they had set traps, iron traps, those are the Persians, where if the Muslims will come, they will be, get trapped in it and naturally die. But it so happened that it became the trap for them, and their horses were trapped in those traps which they were they had set up, and they had to get out of the horses and fight the Muslims. In the end, they lost about 100,000 soldiers were killed. 100,000 soldiers of the patients were killed, and Muslims were just 12,000 in that particular battle. And that was just you may say, the final showdown in which they lost and they ran away, and they could not do anything after. Hardly ever there was many to run away anyway. What I'm trying to tell, if they lost hundreds and thousands of people defending what they think belongs to them, do you think that they have forgotten it 1430 years now? Wallahi, no. By Allah, no. They openly say it, but we can't read. They openly declare it, but we refuse to understand. They openly say this is what we are going to do, but we close our eyes. Why? This is what we are going to know in the next khutbah, inshallah. Inna fi dhalika al-ibra lima tazakkar fatta'idhu ya ulil albab. Inna alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. When Allah made it very clear, لَتَجِدَنَّ أَشَدَّ النَّاسِ عَدَاوَةً لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الْيَهُودَ وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا, that they are the worst of your enemies. How come we recite it every day? How come we understand the meaning? How come we read the translation, but we are not able to relate it to the current events? It is not meant to be something only which is there and you can only relate it to the current affairs of that time. It is meant to be إلى يوم الدين اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. So whatever has happened had happened again, and it has been repeated multiple times, and still it is being repeated today. So we have to be very careful of what is happening in all those places. It is not patience in Arabs. It is not patience in Fulan. It is Islam was shirk wal kufr. This is in the end of the day, this is what it is all about. And that's why we have to be careful. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has warned us multiple times with various narrations we see, with different wordings, such as when he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, ستتداعى عليكم الأمم كما تداعى الأكلة على قصعتها قالوا يا رسول الله أو من قلة نحن يومئذ قال لا أنتم يومئذ كثر ولكنكم غثاء كغثاء السيل ولا ينزعن الله المهابة من قلوب أعدائكم ولا ينزلن في قلوبكم الوهن قالوا يا رسول الله وما الوهن قال حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت وَصَدَقَ رَسُولُهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. In this he says, صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ is warning us, be careful of the time when the enemies will come from everywhere inviting each other to come and kill your people. Kill who? Pakistani? Kill Indians? Kill Afghanis? Kill Iranis? Kill Yemenis? Kill Saudis? Kill who? Kill Muslims. Kill Muslims! تَدَعَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأُمَمَ. To who? Against who? Muslims. He did not single out this and that. No. Based on Islam only. So the Sahabas, they thought that we would be too few in numbers. Rasulullah said, no, you are too many. But the strength of the Iman is gone. You people have nothing of significance in yourself as being a Muslim. Meaning that we lack a lot in that. That is what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And the fear which the kuffar behave from you people would be gone. And the weakness will come and overtake your heart. What is this weakness, Ya Rasulullah? They know, of course we know what is weakness. But they say, what do you really mean? قَالَ حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا وَكَرَهِيَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Your love for this dunya and your fear of death. Our love for this dunya, we are ready to step down from all the rights which Allah has given you. For the love of this dunya, you are ready to disobey each and every command of Allah to get some part of this dunya. Your love for this dunya is so much that you are ready to go over the board in everything so that you can get even one single dollar. Your fear has become, because of the love you have for this dunya, and everything you do stands for this dunya, that you fear dying. If somebody comes and tells you that you are going to die next minute, what will you say? What will really, if you know you are going to die? When the doctor gives you time, you are cancerous, and he says that you have got only 1 week to die. What are you going to do? And here you don't know, maybe in next minute or next second you die, and still you do not fear at all. So let us see among those, at least let us be among those who know, be vigilant and know what is around you, and who your friends are, who your enemies are, who your allies are, and so forth. My brothers and sisters in Islam, it is very important not only to pray, not only to give zakah and perform hajj, but to know what happens to you and the rest of the Muslims if you are not careful enough, if you do not have the strength to stand on your own foot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said, وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَتَعْتُ مِنْ قُوَى, there is a lot of wisdom behind it when Allah is ordering you to be prepared, be strong. Not only in iman, also in physical sense, also in military sense, in every sense. Why? If you are strong, nobody dares to touch you. The ones who are tortured, are they the strong ones? Ones whose countries are invaded by others, are they the strong ones? Never. They are the ones who are always weak. Those who receive are always weak. The rich people, they donate. Receivers are poor people. The rich people, they dominate. Receivers, recipients are those who are poor. So exactly it does apply in every sense of life and living. Wa jazakum la khairan. I pray to Allah that may Allah give us courage and iman and taqwa, and we stand strong for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa la ya'khudhuna fillahi lawmata la'im. Allahumma ansurna على الكفرة والملحدين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك لإعلاء كلمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوى استقيم الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we have our monthly lecture tomorrow. It will start straight after Salat al-Maghrib. Would continue till Salat al-Isha. Dinner would be served straight after Salat al-Isha. You and your families all are welcome. If you have anybody who is not a Muslim and interested, also bring him or her over. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. We are inshallah going to have our Global Messenger Day, 16th of May, in the Outia Square in Auckland City. Biiznillah, more than 50 countries are taking part in it. The theme is about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of you are invited. If you are able to, please do contact us. We will start in this masjid by 9 in the morning, where there will be a small course given, and then after that we would proceed to the city. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Those brothers who are blocking others, please remove your vehicles before you pray your sunnah. Thank you.